One of the benefits of using a logging solution like Sematext is having the ability to centralize your log data in one convenient place. A log agent automatically discovers your logs and metrics and ships that data to the Sematext cloud. This allows you to filter and search through your entire infrastructure in one cloud-based location, which is great. But what if the agent picks up data that you don't want or need? Well, this is where pipelines come in. Pipelines is a new feature in Sematext logs that essentially allows you to process your log data before entering into the Sematext cloud. To do this, we set up processors that can trim off excess data or enrich your log data before they are processed in the Sematext cloud. This makes your data more concise and easier to use, but also, logs that are excluded via pipelines will not be counted towards your total amount of used log data in your plan. Meaning that setting up pipelines will not only make your debugging easier, but it will also save you lots of money in the long run. So let's set up Sematext pipelines. Within your logging app on the Sematext cloud, navigate over to the logs pipeline. This screen may look different if you already have any existing processors. On the top half of the screen, we have our input and our preview. Input is the type of data already coming into the Sematext cloud, and you can choose between the data that the agent has already shipped, or you can experiment with custom logs on this tab here, where you can copy and paste your own logs if you so choose. And the preview on the right-hand side shows what the output from the processors will be. But what are processors? Processors act as the powerhouse within pipelines, executing operations like modifications, exclusions, and generating additional events. These processors connect to one another from top to bottom to create a pipeline. So the ordering of your processors really does matter. You can easily shuffle them around, duplicate them, or delete them as you see fit. But let's add a processor for now. Simply click the Add Processor button, search for and select the type of processor that you want to make. You can parse XML, flatten nested structures, rename fields, add fields, remove fields, and a whole lot more. Check out the docs below for a full breakdown or just try it out for yourself in the link here. Let's make a processor that removes fields. To do this, click Add Processor and select Remove Fields. Give your processor a name and a meaningful description. You can also add filters to only affect certain types of logs if you so choose. Any events failing to meet the filter criteria are automatically excluded from the processor. Now let's select which fields we want to remove. And you can see in the preview section which changes took effect. Let's do another one, but this time let's rename a field. Add Processor, Rename Fields, name it and describe it, filter it if you want, select the existing field, and name the new field. And I'm pretty happy with that. Let's do one last processor. Let's say I really don't need all of my log data, but only some random samples of my data. We can do that by adding a sampling processor. Sampling within the pipeline introduces the capability to selectively sample events. Without filters, sampling applies universally, but with filters, you can precisely decide which subset of events undergo sampling. It's important to know that changes within pipelines are not automatically saved, so once you're happy with your configuration, be sure to click that Save button. Keep in mind that it also might take up to 5 minutes for your changes to go into effect. If you're having trouble with any of this, or you have any questions or concerns, feel free to reach out to us via the link below. And as always, keep monitoring, everybody.